Hi gang, here's a neat heat engine made using material from a coffee bag and that sort of opens and closes like a flower. The petals of the rotating part are strips cut from the coffee bag. Behind it, on one side, is a glass of hot water, meaning the air around it is hot, and on the other side is a glass of cold water, with cold air surrounding it. You can see the petals straighten out in the hot air and curl back up in the cold air, making it an unbalanced wheel that keeps on rotating. It's pretty simple to make, and in this video I'll show you how. For the stator, I've made this stand with scrap wood and two stiff scrap aluminum bars. In this bar, I've made a tiny indentation near the top. I attached some neodymium magnets to one bar, and taped some more to the other bar. For the rotor, I've cut this round plastic disc, and stick a needle through it. By putting the sharp end of the needle in the tiny indentation, and with the help of the magnetic fields, the needle just sits there and turns very easily. But the disc is unbalanced, always coming to a stop with the same side down. So I sand away some plastic from that side. It still isn't balanced, so I sand some more, until finally the rotor stays pretty much however I orient it. Then I start cutting up the coffee bag, and cut a strip from it. The strip is a half inch wide by 2 1/8 inches long. A piece of duct tape holds it onto the disc. Then I attach another piece, and make sure they both stretch out the same distance from the center. But notice that one petal always hangs down, so the whole thing is unbalanced. After trimming a little from the petal that was hanging down, the rotor balance is better now. I give the petals a little curvature, using the blunt edge of a pair of scissors. I then put out two glasses of water, one hot and one cold, along with the stand and the heat engine's rotor. From the top, you can see this petal straightening out in the hot air surrounding the glass containing hot water, and this petal curling up in the cold air surrounding the glass containing cold water. Eventually, I add all 8 petals, but notice that since it's now heavier, I've also had to add more magnets. And as you'd expect, the rotor is unbalanced again, with the same side always hanging down. To fix it this time, I add a little extra tape on the opposite side, and now it stays put wherever I leave it. It's balanced. After using the scissors again to give all the petals a curvature, I give it a try. All that careful measuring and balancing has paid off, as it works the first time. You can see the petals straighten out on the hot side, and curl up again on the cold side. There's not a lot of power here, but it's pretty neat to watch. Well, thanks for watching. Check out these other interesting videos too. That includes one with more demonstrations of this heat engine in action, and an explanation of how it works. Another on how to make a corona motor, another neat rotating device. And one about how to do wireless transmission of electricity using a Joule Thief circuit. And don't forget to subscribe if you like these videos, or give a thumbs up, share with your social media, or leave a question or comment below. See you in a bit.